Let's consider some examples of those U groups. We've already considered some. Let's make the N a little bit bigger this time, though. Let's compare and contrast. Oh, let's say U16 versus U20. First of all, what are they as sets? U16 consists of all positive integers less than 16 that are relatively prime to 16. So all of the odd numbers, right? Positive odd numbers less than 16. 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, 13, 15. Under what operation? It's multiplication, not addition here, right? Mod 16. That's a group. A group of order 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. What about U20? 20 is 2 squared times 5. We want to avoid even numbers. We also want to avoid multiples of 5. 1, 3, skip 5, go up to 7, 9, 11, 13, skip 15, go up to 17 and 19. This is under multiplication mod 20. So both of these groups have order 8. The order of U16 and the order of U20 in both cases is 8. They are both abelian. These are observations here. U16 and U20 are abelian. When you multiply integers, modulo, whatever, you do get commutativity holding. Those are a couple basic observations. Here's a question. Is either group cyclic or not? How would we answer that question? Probably the best way to do it is just go start computing orders of elements. So let's consider U16 first. Might as well just start with the smallest one that's not the identity, like 3. Do as many of these calculations without a calculator as possible, as reasonable, but I'll have my calculator ready just in case. We're doing multiplication mod 16, 3 squared is 9. 3 cubed, of course, is 27. Mod 16, though, is 11. 3 to the 4th is 81. Also could be thought of as 33, 3 times 11. Mod 16 is 1. Oh, okay, so 3 has order 4, it looks like. 1 is the identity. 3 has order 4. You get to write crazy-looking equations like that in this class. What about 5? 5 squared is 25, mod 16 is 9. Five cubed could be thought of as 5 times 9 is 45, mod 16 is 13. 5 to the 4th, you could do it as 5 times 13, what's that? 65, right? Double check me. 65 mod 16 is 1. Right? 16 goes evenly into 64. 65 mod 16 is 1. Order of 5 is also 4. What about 7? 7 squared is 49. 49 mod 16 is 1. 16 goes evenly into 48. The order of 7 is 2. What about the order of 9? 9 squared is 81. 81 mod 16 is 1, right? 16 goes evenly into 80. 16 times 5 is 80. The order of 9 is 2. We're not, so far, we're not getting any elements of order 8. Seems like U16 might not be cyclic. 11 squared, 121, mod by 16. 16 goes evenly into 80, into 96, and 112. Looks like this is going to be a 9. Oh, wait, I can already use, I can use what I've done to take this, these two bits of information and say right away that 11 to the 4th must be 1. Because 11 to the 4th will be 11 squared squared, 9 squared, which will be 1. Looks like 11 has order 4. Only two elements left, 13 and 15. 13 squared is 169. 16 goes evenly into 160. This is 9. That's going to imply, once again, that if I raise it to the 4th power, I'll get back to 1. And by the way, if I raise it, if I square it and don't get 1, I'm not going to get 1 ready to raise it to the 3rd power in this case because, well, I'm using something I haven't told you. The order of elements has to divide the order of the group. I'm telling you right now. Maybe you've noticed that pattern already. The order of the group is 8. The order of any element's got to be either 1, 2, 4, or 8. It's got to divide the order of the group. Can't possibly be 3 in this group. Ultimately, the order of 13 is 4. 15 squared, 225. Maybe I'll rely on my calculator now for speed. 225 divided by 16 is 14 and a little bit more. Looks like the remainder is going to be 1. That's a calculation that confirms the remainder is 1. 15 squared equals 1. 15 has order 2. No elements of order 8. U16 is not a cyclic group. U16 is not cyclic, or you could say non-cyclic. What about U20? Maybe it's cyclic, maybe it's not. I give myself a ton of room here. In U20, 3 squared is 9, 3 cubed is 27, mod 20 is 7. It's a little easier to do calculations in your head, mod 20. 3 to the 4th is 3 times 7 is 21, mod 20 is 1. The order of 3 is 4 again. Remember that 5 is not in U20 because 5 divides evenly into 20. It's not relatively prime to 20. What about 7? 7 squared is 49. 49 mod 9 is, mod 20 is 9. Oh, wow. The same thing's going to happen, right? Because we got 9 in both spots again. Seven to the 4th is going to be 1. The order of both 3 and 7 is going to be 4. If you're unsure, you can use your technology. 7 to the 4th, 2,401. We're modding by 20. Divide that by 20, you're going to get a remainder of 1. In fact, U20 is not going to be cyclic either. If we compute the orders of other elements, we're still not going to get any elements of order 8. We're modding by 20. The order of 9 and the order of 11 is 2. 13 squared is 169, mod 20 is 9. Same kind of thing is going to happen with 13 as happened with 3 and 7. 13 to the 4th is going to be the identity. Same kind of thing is going to happen with 17. 17 squared is 289, I believe. Yep, 289 mod 20 is 9. Keep getting 9s there when we square those. 17 to the 4th is going to be 1. The order of 13 and 17 is going to be 4. What about 19 squared? That's 381. Mod 20 is 1. The order of 19 is 2. So this is also non-cyclic. Are these U groups always not cyclic? No, sometimes they are cyclic. Can I think of an example? Maybe with a bigger value of n. Let me try. I'm going to try U18. We could also ask the question, yeah, U16 and U20 are not cyclic. Are they possibly isomorphic? Do they have the same form when I make their Cayley tables in certain ways? What about U18? 18 is 2 times 3 squared. So in writing out its elements, I want to avoid even numbers and multiples of 3. 1, 5, 7, avoid 9, jump to 11, 13, 17. This one's only got 6 elements. Is it possibly cyclic? Does it have a generator? Any elements with order 6? U18 itself has order 6. What about the elements? 5 squared is 25, mod 18 is 7. 5 cubed is going to be 5 times 7 is 35, mod 18 is going to be 17. 5 to the 4th, I could think of it as 5 times 17, that'll be 85. Mod 18, a little hard to do these calculations in your head. 85 divided by 18 is that. What's the remainder? It's 13. 18 goes evenly into 72. Remember I said a few minutes ago, the order of any element has to divide the order of the group. The order of the group is 6. This element has order bigger than 4. It's got to have order 6. 5 to the 5th is 13 times 5 is 65. Mod 18, 18 goes evenly again into 72. It also goes evenly into 54. 65 minus 54, remainder is 11. 5 to the 6th better be the identity. It's 5 times 11 is 55, mod 18, 18 goes evenly into 54, this is a 1. Therefore, the order of 5 is 6, therefore I can say right away, U18 is cyclic. And I can also say it's generated by 5, it's 5 as a generator, could write that. Do you think there'd be any other generators based on what you've seen so far? Maybe in the reading in chapter 4, if you've started that, which you should have by now. Five is a generator of a group of order, a cyclic group of order 6. Another generator is going to be a power of 5, where the power is another number relatively prime to 6, 5. In other words, 11 should be a generator. Is it? 11 to the 1st, of course, is itself. 11 squared is 121. 121 mod 18 is 13. 18 goes evenly into 108. What this is verifying. 11 cubed. It's going to be 13 times 11. That's going to be 143. 13 times 11. Divide by 18. What's the remainder? Subtract 7 and multiply by 18. The remainder is 17. 11 cubed is 17. Its order has got to be bigger than 3. It's got to be 6. This is going to be a generator. 11 to the fourth will be 11 times 17. What's the remainder when I divide by 18? It's 7. Is 11 times 7 is 77, divide by 18. 18 goes evenly into 72. So the remainder is 5. And then 11 to the 6th would be 11 times 5 is 55. Divide by 18, the remainder is 1. So therefore, 11 is also a generator. We can write that U18 is also generated by 11. And it turns out there are going to be no other generators. This is a cyclic group. It actually only has, it's got two generators. Every other element is going to generate a cyclic subgroup of this. But it turns out, even though cyclic subgroups can have more than one generator, there's only going to be one cyclic subgroup of each order that divides the order of the group. What did I just say? The order of the group is 6. What are the numbers that divide 6? 1, 2, 3, and 6. 4 subgroups. The trivial group, just 1 by itself. A cyclic subgroup of order 2. 2 divides 6. What would be that? If you think about it, it's got to be 17, 5 cubes, got to be the one element of order 2, because that means 17 squared is 55, which is 1. Well, 17 squared, if you don't believe me, it's not 55 right off the bat. Divide this by 18, the remainder is going to be 1. You can see that. 17 is the one element of order 2. It's going to generate the unique cyclic subgroup order 2. The other elements, besides 1, 5, 11, and 1, 5, 11, what did I just talk about? And 17. 7 and 13 are going to have order 3. They're going to generate a cyclic subgroup for order 3. That may feel like that was too much to process in such a short amount of time. Once again, you got to spend some time thinking about this. Go through this example again. Work through it again. Try to see if you can rediscover the things I said. I mean, you can watch this part of this video again if you want. What I'm saying is fundamental for understanding chapter 4. I'm highlighting something called the fundamental theorem of cyclic groups. Sounds important. It is.